Good morning, Wildcats, and happy Friday morning to everyone. Hopefully this Friday just feels a little sweeter because of testing being done. But more on that in just a minute. This week has been Every Kid Healthy Week. So we'd first like to say thank you to everyone that participated in getting information out to students this week as we end with Fitness Friday. So again, thank you to all those that were involved in making this week happen for the information for the announcements for Every Kid Healthy Week. And that brings us to Fitness Friday. So thank you to our PE department and Ms. Aguilar for the information, letting us know that physical fitness can be broken down really into two parts. And those two parts are skill-related fitness and health-related fitness. So when you're looking at those two components of physical fitness, the skill-related fitness are factors that relate with the possibility of you becoming a good athlete. So when you're looking at skill-related fitness, questions you might be looking at are you fast? Do you have good hand-eye coordination? Can you throw a ball? Health-related fitness relates to how well the systems of your body operate. Are your heart and other muscles of your body in good shape? So when we look at fitness over long term, you look at both components of skill-related fitness and health-related fitness. Now, in order to understand more about those two, some of the things that you will hear related to skill-related fitness are things like agility, balance, coordination, power, reaction time, and speed, which are all related to fitness, but skill-related fitness, where with health-related fitness, you would hear things more like body composition, cardiovascular fitness, flexibility, muscular endurance, and muscular strength. So those are your two components of physical fitness. Now, obviously, fitness has a lot more to do with all your parts of the body, as well as physical fitness. But when you think of physical fitness, it can be broken down into these two components, and then these are some of your related terms that you would see to fitness. So again, thank you to our PE department today for letting us know a little bit more about fitness. All right, and I bring up the testing schedule only to say thank you to all those that were involved in making testing happen. I know that it was a lot more difficult than in previous years, just making sure that all of our in-person students were testing, all of our distance learning students were testing. So thank you to all of our staff that made testing possible. Thank you to all of our parents that helped with the flexibility of the schedule. And then, of course, a big thank you to all of our students that worked hard and did their best to do their best on the test. All right, so testing is done except for makeups. And since today is Friday, we are all on the same schedule. So we will start in the morning with our virtual check-in from 8:35 to 9:35. Then the morning should be spent in office hours with your teachers, finishing up the assignments for the week, if you have any that are still late because grades will be turned in today. And then in the afternoon, you should be finishing up any Reading Plus or any other assignments that you need to get done that you haven't already gotten done. And again, just a reminder that grades are being submitted today. It is your final progress marks before final grades are turned in at the end of the year. So make sure to spend the schedule today getting those assignments completed and making sure that you're going to the Google Classroom and finishing your assignments that are there for you. All righty. As Weaver Wildcats, we live the Weaver way. And with that, we also celebrate Student of the Month for being recognized for these different areas of behavioral expectations, which are work responsibly, have that excellent behavior, that can-do attitude of achievement, make sure we're valuing every single person, making sure that we're also exhibiting respect to all those, and we are ready to learn. And so for this month's Student of the Month, teachers recognize students for their attitude of achievement. And so we have a short video clip recognizing those students now. again, we'd like to say congratulations to all those students that were recognized by their teachers for their can-do attitude of achievement. All right, let's make sure that we're also continuing to do our part to help stop the spread of the coronavirus. So make sure you continue to wash your hands frequently and thoroughly. You're practicing that good respiratory hygiene. You avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth. Make sure that when you're out, you're wearing your face coverings and social distancing. And if you're feeling sick, stay home and take that time to get yourself better. So also remember that during distance learning, these are the things that are going to help you do better, which is checking your school Gmail account and your Google Classroom every day. Hopefully, we're not still doing the little trick of just clicking the button without doing the work in classroom. But if you are doing that, let's make sure we're getting that work done in Google Classroom. Let's make sure we're checking into our daily class meetings, especially as we get to more of a normal schedule for at least a couple weeks with testing done. Make sure you're watching the daily announcements for all the changes that might occur and important things going around school. And then make sure that you're also taking those brain breaks to get up, move around, and getting that blood flowing through your body. All right. I want to say a big thank you to everybody that participated in Wildcat Wednesday for this last week of Superhero Day. And we're going to go ahead and take that time now to celebrate Superhero Day. So again, we would like to thank everyone that participated in Superhero Day last week, and we want to extend the invitation and the challenge to everyone to make Tuesday even bigger, because we will not be having Wildcat Wednesday on Wednesday. That makes me scratch my head. But we will be having our Spirit Day on Tuesday, because Tuesday is May the 4th, which is Star Wars Day. So make sure for Star Wars Day to wear your favorite Star Wars gear for Star Wars Day. May the 4th be with you. So again, that will be on Tuesday for Wildcat Wednesday on Tuesday. I know, Wildcats, but we're celebrating Tuesday. Alrighty, we want to say big good luck today to our cross country team as they compete in their final meet of the year against McSwain. Congratulations to all those students for all their hard work this season in cross country. And we want to wish our softball girls and our baseball boys good luck as they get ready for their game Monday against Winton. So again, that's our softball girls. They'll be playing against Winton at Weaver. And then our baseball boys will be playing Winton in Winton. Again, that's on Monday. All right, Wildcats, that's what we have for you for this Friday edition of our announcements. Again, big thank you for testing, getting wrapped up this week, for everyone's hard work for that. And remember, Wildcats, each one of you is great. Just allow yourselves to be. Have a great weekend.